today?
We're here today outside the Bahraini embassy to support Nabil Rajab's case for freedom of expression and to show our solidarity that words shouldn't be shut down. He should not be imprisoned right now for having tweeted about the Saudi-led war against Yemen. This is a violation of his human rights.
And do you think the UK is doing enough to speak out about the situation in Bahrain and the violation of human rights?
I haven't really seen much momentum from our politicians, particularly from the party and government. In kind of contrast, I think that they seem to be very friendly with Bahrain. I know that Theresa May was there in December last year and didn't really get much hint that she was putting pressure on them to free Nabil and the other prisoners of conscience there.
And do you think that the UK should sell weapons to Bahrain?
Oh, we're certainly not. I think that is an abomination that we're complicit in the suffering of so many Yemeni people. I think that humanity is more important than commerce and making some money. I think we could be making money in far better, kinder ways.
I'm here today to support the campaign to free Nabil Rajab in Bahrain. But I work for the Such Campaign for Freedom in the UAE, and these issues overlap between the two countries, and you know, throughout the Gulf they have the same issues of human rights defenders getting locked up for criticising their government policies. So I think the campaigns are better if they connect the whole kind of region as and deal with such things as the ending the British arms trade to the Gulf as a whole, which includes obviously Saudi Arabia, Bahrain and United Arab Emirates, as kind of a collective thing to kind of campaign, focus campaign on.